Hi friends, welcome to our channel Celtic Learning Solution. And today's video is a product review on Maybelline Colossal Super Black Kajal. So this is my first review and I hope you guys like it. To begin with, I have been a kajal person all my life. I started using kajal somewhere around 2000 when I was in the 7th standard. Until about 2013, that is the only thing I have used. I have used no other makeup products. Sometimes maybe a little bit of gloss or lipstick here and there, but hardly anything else. It's always been a kajal. So I thought this is like a perfect beginning to my product reviews, and I shall dedicate my first review to the love of my life, and it's like a basic necessity, a kajal. So I was just going through the Maybelline website one day and I saw their new launch coming up and I got like super excited. So I checked online, but there was nothing available online, couldn't buy it anywhere. And then I saw it on Amazon, however the product was out of stock. And then I clicked on that little link over there which said that they send you an email when the product is available. So I did that, and then as soon as I got the email, I ordered this baby. So this one is for rupees 299 or 300, I'm not very sure. I'll put all the description and all the price and everything in the description box below, so you can check it out there. I got it from Amazon and it came in this packaging. I really like the packaging. The earlier one was yellow with black accents, and this one is black with yellow accents, so I somehow like this better. And it has super black written on it with 2x blacker, 1 smooth stroke, 16-hour intense waterproof. So the earlier one was 12-hour and this one is 16-hour, so that is what it claims. Moving on to the kajal pencil, this is again a black pencil with yellow accents and all the product names written on it. I really like the way it looks. It just gives me like those kicks, you know, when I see any new kajal pencil. It's the normal retractable pencil. I've already used it, so yeah, there you go. And it is 0.35 grams for 299 rupees, which is okay because that's how much of product you get in these retractable pencils. The product claims that it's 2 times darker than its previous original Colossal Kajal, and I completely agree. It is definitely twice as dark as the original Colossal. Let me show you the swatches. So as you can see, the swatches are really dark, especially the double and the multiple swatches are really dark. And the best part about this kajal is that it sets to a really matte finish, which I so love. As far as waterproof and smudge proof claim is concerned, this kajal is completely waterproof and smudge proof, at least on my hand. So now I'll show you how smudge proof the kajal is. I have applied these swatches around 10 to 15 seconds ago, and I'm rubbing it. And you can see that the kajal has hardly budged. And I'm rubbing it pretty vigorously. I'm sure nobody rubs their eyes that hard. So yes, the kajal will stay for as long as you like. Let me try it with some water on it now. As you can see, even now, the kajal may have gone a slightly lighter to its previous pigmentation. However, it still is pretty intact. It definitely doesn't smudge, which I really like, because I have a major smudging problem. My kajal just never ever stays on the waterline. And now for the final test, I'm going to apply some cleanser on it and see how it fares with the cleansing milk. So honestly, I actually hope this comes out with the cleansing milk, because I don't want cleaning this up to be an issue. Okay, it doesn't really come off. Yeah, so you really have to rub hard for it to come off, even with the cleansing milk, and even then you can still see the stains on my hands. So the kajal fared really well on my hand, and the swatches were completely smudge proof and waterproof, and even the cleanser, it took really long. Now, I've used this Kajal for almost 2 weeks now, and I can give you an honest review about it. That for one, it is really smooth and it glides on very smooth on the waterline as well. Now, I like my Kajal very thick, and hence I also put a dash of Kajal on on my lower lash line along with the waterline. So in that area, however, this Kajal smudged a bit. So every time I put it under my lash, or rather over my lash line, it smudges. But on the waterline, it stays for about good 6 to 8 hours, depending on what activity I have been involved in. And that is a long time for any Kajal to stay on my eyes. Trust me, guys, I have like the most oily lids on the face of earth. I generally do not like using my Kajals on my upper lash line. I like to keep them different because of safety reasons. However, for this review, I also used it on my upper lash line, and it lasted for a good 10 to 12 hours on my upper lash line. So that definitely this Kajal lasts for around 12 hours. However, I still would not give in to the 16-hour claim. Maybe it's just my eyes because they're watery and oily. It might just last longer on your eyes. So now for the final test, I'm going to apply this on my waterline and you can see how it looks. So let's see how this Kajal actually looks on my waterline. So as you can see, this Kajal goes very smooth on the waterline. It does not tug at all. I had this problem with the earlier Colossal. I used to think that it tugs, and it's pretty intense on the waterline as well. I'll show you how it looks on my lash line also. So this is how the Kajal looks on my eyes. If I can come a little closer for a better view. This is how I like to line my eyes with Kajal. I like thick Kajal, so it looks really good. However, as mentioned, on the lower lash line, it does smudge and it, you know, gives my eyes a little bit of dark circles. Not a lot, however, a bit of dark circles, which I don't quite enjoy. So generally, I line my eyes with a Kajal and then I just underline it on the lash line with a liquid liner, because then it stays longer. So to quickly sum up about the Colossal Super Black Kajal, I love the packaging, I love the texture, it's really really smooth and it goes very smooth on my waterline. It definitely is darker than the previous Colossal Kajal. I like the fact that it sets to a really nice matte finish. It does stay long on my waterline and it does stay really long on my upper lash line. It does not sting or irritate or make my eyes red, so that's also a very good point about this. Now, a few things that I didn't really like about this product: it does not stay true to a 16-hour claim. It does not stay on for 16 hours on my upper lash line, my lower lash line, or my waterline, so nowhere. Also, I feel that 300 rupees for this is slightly more expensive. I would not really want to spend 300 rupees on a Kajal which is very similar to the Colossal, earlier Colossal Kajal, but darker. Just the pigmentation wouldn't be a criteria for me to spend so much more on this Kajal. And also, there's no ingredient list mentioned on the packaging, so that for me is a little bit of something that I don't like. So yeah, that's all about the Colossal Kajal Super Black. Would I recommend it to you guys? Yes, definitely. It's one Kajal, you should try it out, especially if you're a Colossal Kajal fan. You should try it out. It's a great Kajal. Would I buy it again? Well, not anytime soon, because I would like to try more Kajals out there in the market. So as of now, I'm done. This should last me for a while and then I would not want to buy the same Kajal again. So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. If you did, do comment below in the comment section and do tell us what more you'd like to watch. We also have videos coming up on image management and how to manage your image effectively. So do keep watching, do like and subscribe to our channel. Until the next video, bye-bye.